Hello, I'm Andy Howard. This video shows how ADS's load pull simulation capabilities make it easy for you to explore the design space and obtain optimum performance from your power amplifier device. Both experienced and new ADS users should find it worth watching. In our constant power delivered load pull videos, I showed a few new load pull simulation setups that were added to ADS 2009 Update 1. After the release, we updated the load pull design guide again, improving most of the data displays and adding 9 new simulation setups. These setups assume you are designing a power amplifier and have a nonlinear device model. I recommend that you run load pull simulations in a sequence of steps. In the first step, you hold the available source power constant, you vary the load reflection coefficient, and you see how the power delivered to the load depends on the reflection coefficient. This simulation will tell you whether you have the device biased properly and whether you're specifying a good region of the Smith chart over which to sweep the load. Subsequently, you'll want to progress to the constant power delivered load pull simulations, in which the available source power is adjusted until the desired power is delivered to each load reflection coefficient. We start with the first schematic by selecting one tone constant available source power load pull. This copies a sample schematic into your ADS project. To simulate your own device, you would delete the sample device, replace it with your own. You have to specify the bias network, modify it if needed. You'd specify the available source power, the input frequency, and you also have to specify the region of the Smith chart over which to sweep the load reflection coefficient. A data display is also copied into your project. This one shows contours of constant power delivered, as well as contours of constant power added efficiency. We've added listing columns that show the maximum power delivered and contour levels, as well as the maximum power added efficiency and contour levels. And notice that these contour levels are now round numbers. You can see the contour levels from the marker readout. So in this case, the contour is at 28 dBm. You can easily change the contour step size as well as the number of lines just by editing an equation. The boxes to the left make it easy for you to make trade-offs between maximum power and maximum power added efficiency. These data show that the device is producing a reasonable amount of power, has a reasonable amount of gain, has decent power added efficiency, but we don't know anything at all about how far into compression it is or how much distortion it's producing. At this point, we could move directly to a constant power delivered load pull simulation, or we could sweep the available source power and see how the gain compression characteristics of the device are. This schematic is the same as before, except that now we've added a sweep of the available source power. The data display is similar to what was shown earlier, except that now all the data corresponds to a particular available source power, which you select by moving a marker. We've also added gain and gain compression contours. We've added plots to the left which show the gain and gain compression characteristics of the device when you select the load for maximum power delivered or maximum power added efficiency or minimum gain compression. These plots allow you to quickly see how much power you can get from a device as well as how far into gain compression the device will be when delivering that particular power. At this point, you could use one of the new simulation schematics to sweep any other parameter on the schematic. For example, the input frequency or some bias voltage. If you know your device needs to deliver a particular output power, we can move directly to those schematics for simulating constant power delivered load pull. We've added the ability to sweep some arbitrary parameter while maintaining a constant power delivered to the load. We've added second and third harmonic load pulls under constant power delivered conditions. These are useful if you want to try to optimize power added efficiency. We've added a constant power delivered source pull simulation, which is useful for optimizing gain. We've added various two-tone simulations, which include all the data from the one-tone simulations, as well as intermodulation distortion. It's also quite possible and reasonable to proceed to load pull simulations with modulated signals. If you do this, you can see results such as adjacent channel power ratio directly from your load pull simulations rather than trying to infer this data from two-tone intermodulation distortion simulations. For more information on the current release of ADS, please visit our website. Supported customers may download this updated load pull design guide from our Knowledge Center.